My name is Christopher Calderon, Project Manager for Cervion Systems, and in today's video, we'll be going over the new dashboard menu editor. All of your items are organized into menus and categories. Before we start programming, we should understand how to organize all your items so they can easily be found by your staff. Menus are the different groups along the top of your screen. Think lunch or dinner menus. This allows us to share the same item in different menus at different prices. Next, we have categories. These are logical groupings of menu items like salads or soups or entrees. This is also where we can assign a default revenue group and printer. We can also override this later. Our menu items will be assigned a category. So for example, Caesar salad lives in the salad category. So let's take a look at the menu editor. When creating a new menu, you need a unique name. If you would like a different name to show up online, put it in the readable name for guest field. Next, set the menu's priority. This is the order in which it will appear on screen. If multiple menus have the same priority, they'll be sorted in alphabetical order. And don't forget, always remember to check enabled. You can set the type to be general or to go. If you set the type to be to go, it will put to go in front of all items. You can choose a revenue center if necessary, or use the default revenue center. This can be used to determine which users have access to this menu. For example, a site with a restaurant and pizza place. We assign the pizza menu to only show up to users assigned the pizza revenue group. Next, set the subsystem visibility. What this means is, where can I view this menu from? Terminal is for front of house iPads. Online is for online ordering. Digital menu is for a viewable menu online. Dine in allows customers to scan a QR code on your table and place an order from their phones. And finally, PAX ordering is for taking orders directly on a handheld credit card reader. Finally, we can set the visible time intervals if we only want the menu to appear at a certain time, like a brunch or holiday menu. Now let's take a look at the category editor. Categories are how we separate different items into different families, like sandwiches and salads or rum and vodka. These are items that will be on the same page of your POS and generally follow the same rules. When creating a new category, we need a unique name, and if you would like to have a different name show up, again, we're going to use the readable name for guest. You can also put a description of the category that will show up above the items on online ordering. So you can say something like, all sandwiches come with fries. The next field, parent, allows us to have a category be subcategorized under something else. For example, a category of red wines, and you want to have it divided up even further to things like Merlot or Pinot Noir, Cabernet. Next, we choose a revenue group. This is where we can assign the report category. Now, if you would like to organize your menu using colors, we'll assign it into the category, and every item inside that category will inherit that color. Priority, again, is the order the item will show up on the menu. This is not inherited from the category. But the best practice is to assign the same priority to the menu items inside the category. Now, when I'm programming menus, I usually go through and map out my priorities ahead of time. A good rule of thumb is to separate them by 10, so you can rearrange things as needed. For example, salad priority 10, sandwich priority 20. But if I want a certain item to be at the bottom of the salad list, maybe for optional dressings, I'll assign that specific item priority of 11. Priority for online ordering follows the same rules as before, but is only applicable for online ordering pages. The gift card box is a special flag. Only enable that if you plan to sell gift cards out of that category. Gift cards and only gift cards. Next, we have visible rows and columns. This will let you override the default button layout for this category. And finally, the last thing you need to do is assign printers. Here you will see three fields at the bottom of the page. Name, this is where you choose the printer you're assigning. Section, this is where you can choose a print rule to only apply to a specific room. And job role. This determines which job role this rule applies to. We'll go deeper into print routing in a later video. But just know that so long as you pick a printer from the list, all rooms and job types will have it print to that printer. If you just leave the other fields blank, it applies to everyone. A common request is that only the servers have drinks print, not bartenders. To set that up, we would do the following. Set the name to be GC1 bar, leave the section blank, and then set the job role to server. This will make all drinks placed by employees tagged as server print to the GC1 bar printer. Now that we've created a menu and its categories, it's time to start creating items to populate them. Inside the menu editor, you'll see several options for creating your items, but not all are necessary to fill out. Only fields marked with a red asterisk are necessary. First, we need to assign a category. You'll choose one you already created from the list. Next, give the item a unique name. Now, there are four fields for names. Name, this is going to be your unique name that the system will use. Short name, if a name is too long for the buttons, a short name can be used instead. This will only show up on the POS buttons. You have kitchen name. Here you can assign a different name to print on kitchen tickets. This can be in another language or shorthand. And the last name is readable name for guests. This is what shows up on the online ordering page. If you're using online ordering, it's always a good idea to write a description of the item and to include a picture. For the priority field, you should copy the priority from category to make sure everything in said category is grouped together. Product ID is for sites that use scanners. This is where you can assign an SKU. Next, we have course line, if you'd like to pre-assign the course for this item. Now, this is numerical only, so course 1, course 2, course 3, not app, dessert, etc. To go tax-free, choose this if to-go orders are not taxed in your state. Ask price and ask name are for creating open items and market price items. Tax inclusive will include the tax in the item's price. By default, taxes are assigned by the revenue group, so you only have to assign a tax here if you're overwriting the default assigned to that group. The next two items are for creating combos, which will be addressed in another video. When building out items, just make sure can be sold itself is checked. Color is inherited from the category, but you can override it here. Measured item and measurement unit can be used if you're selling things by weight. If you check the measured item box and put in a measurement unit, you'll be prompted to enter the weight when selling an item. For example, pounds, grams, liters, however. If you would like to track costs through the POS, you can put the production cost in the cost field. The Fast Screen Enabled button will put this item on the Fast Bar screen that can be enabled at the iPad level. If you're looking at an item that already has modifiers assigned, you'll now see them listed below. We'll go deeper into modifiers in a later video, but from this screen, you can see what's assigned. If you'd like to take a closer look at the modifier, press the arrow button and it will take you directly to the modifier group. If you keep scrolling past the mods, you'll see assigned printers. From here, we can override the category's print settings. And finally, at the bottom of the screen is prices. Here you'll see any menus you've created and can assign a price if you'd like. While you could go to each item and price them individually, one of EdgeServ's greatest strengths is the price editor. From here, you can sort all of your items and edit the prices of entire categories at once. On top, we have our sorting options and a search field. Now, we can price out everything all at once. Just remember to save when moving between pages. And one of the best features, items can be at different prices in different menus. Some tips and tricks. Instead of creating every menu item from scratch, build one item in a category and test it on the POS to make sure it works. Then go and duplicate it. At that point, you'll just have to change the name. Another tip, plan your menu priorities in advance. This will save you time and make it easier to make the menu flow logically together. Another, more personal preference is use pastel colors, as they're easier on the eyes than bright colors. Color coding your menu can also make it easier to remember the layout and to find your items. Thank you for watching. If you have any other questions about menu editing or any EdgeServ questions in general, please reach out to support. We're happy to help. Have a good day.